The Roman poet Horace once said, "Adversity has the effect of eliciting talents, which in prosperous circumstances would have lain dormant." In other words, times of struggle inspire efforts in individuals that lead them to develop solutions to issues at hand. Throughout American history, we have seen circumstances of people overcoming hardships with these efforts, and thus creating a more prosperous and desired society. Good afternoon. My name is Arima Malcolm Parker, and today I'll be presenting the question, to what extent have moral threats to human development in the United States during the 20th century yielded efforts that encourage societal progress? But before I begin, let's define what moral threats to human development are. According to the Measure of America Project by the Social Science Research Council, human development is defined as the process of enlarging people's freedoms and opportunities and improving their well-being. With a greater amount of human development, there is more freedom for people to decide who to be, what to do, and how to live. Now, for a threat to human development would be circumstances that prevent people from accessing these opportunities. And a moral threat would be one such circumstance that does so on the basis of immoral standards, such as racism or discrimination. For many people in the United States during the 20th century, this was the case. I'll be focusing specifically on women and African Americans. Their various protests and demonstrations against moral threats led to the women's suffrage and civil rights movements. These movements led to the reforms of societal standards and policies that allowed these threats to exist. Which brings me to my point, that moral threats to human development for women and African Americans led to efforts that actually prompted actions from government and society pushing States towards being a better democracy with greater equality. Taking a look at moral threats to human development for women, we can see that these started to take hold in the colonial era. According to the AMSCO publication, United States History, men were the main source, mainly worked as farmers. Land owning was reserved to men. They were the head of the household and dominated politics, while women were limited to household chores and child rearing, which shows that men were made to be the superior sex. And because women were regarded as inferior, they were denied things such as legitimate citizenship, voting rights, property rights, and opportunities like equal education and work positions. In the 20th century, Bob Dylan published the song Blowing in the Wind, where he asks several questions asking when injustices in the United States will end. One such question is, how many times can a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? In the circumstance of women, this is a question asked when people will start to pay attention to the injustices against women or start to address them. In the 20th century, with the women's suffrage movement, American women protested the moral threat of discrimination as it applied to their voting rights. According to the Library of Congress, they used efforts such as picketing outside of the White House to pressure the government to take action, organizing large-scale parades to draw attention to their cause, and even lobbying or seeking influence from Congress to pass legislation for more equal rights. So what did these efforts achieve? The passing of the 19th Amendment to the United States Constitution, which states that citizens of the U.S., their right to vote cannot be denied or abridged on the account of sex. Now, this was a step towards equality, but in a broader perspective, it pushed the U.S. towards being a better democracy, because it allowed more of the citizen population to participate in actions that influence the government. And the implications of this being a government for the people by a greater number of the people, now that women were included. Transitioning to moral threats to human development against African Americans, we can see, according to the AMSCO publication, United States History, that this started to take hold due to the institution of slavery. It states that white colonists adopted laws to keep African Americans in bondage for life. And despite their emancipation in 1863, even more legal policies were implemented to prevent them from accessing their opportunities. The greatest being Jim Crow laws, implemented mainly in the southern states of the U.S. These laws wanted to keep whites and blacks separate through various segregation practices and wanted to maintain that status of inferiority for African Americans. They were denied the right to vote, equal access to schools and thus education, and even housing opportunities. So how did they combat these threats? With powerful demonstrations that became known as the Civil Rights Movement, Martin Luther King Jr., recognized as the leader of the Civil Rights Movement, stressed the use of nonviolent protest to combat these moral threats. In his letter from Birmingham Jail, King says that nonviolent protests dramatize the issue that can no longer be ignored, racism and discrimination, and is necessary for growth, meaning that nonviolent protests such as peaceful marches and even boycotts would yield efforts to promote societal growth. In addition, violent protests or militant acts were also used, such as those as the 1965 LA Watts riots. These violent demonstrations prompted more action in society for change. Looking at the effects of the Civil Rights Movement, we can see that multiple civil rights legislations were passed, such as the Civil Rights Act of 1964, which outlawed discrimination, the Voting Rights Act of 1965, making this outlawing discriminatory voting practices, and the Civil Rights Act of 1968, which made equal opportunities for housing for all people. With that being said, we can come to the conclusion that moral threats to human development for women and African Americans yielded societal progress by pushing us, the U.S., towards being a better democracy with greater equality, because they prompted the passing of legislation such as the 19th Amendment and the Civil and Voting Rights Acts, the implications of which creating a for democracy, allowing more civic participation amongst the citizen population, and equality, as it allowed for an equal access of rights and privileges for majorities and minorities alike. Now, the greatest limitation to these legislations is that although they prevented moral threats from existing in society, they cannot change a person's personal support or belief for them. So eliminating circumstances that allow these threats to exist cannot stop a person from either maintaining their belief for discrimination or acts of racism. Thank you. What questions do you have?
All right, thank you, Rima. I got two questions for you. First up, how did you select the strategies you used to gather information, and were they effective?
So earlier in the year, we had done an activity where we used the academic OneFile container as a source of source for doing our research. So I used that. I went back to the academic OneFile as like a skill that we had learned earlier in the year, and from there I found sources that I could use, or by looking them up, I found even more sources with more details for my presentation.
Were they effective? Would you say that's effective?
Yes, because it provides a variety of sources, not just articles or newspapers, it can give you media as well.
So. All right, and the second question. If you had more time, what additional research would you do?
I would probably go into more not as popular social movements that occurred in against moral threats to human development, such as the gay rights movement, which is not as commonly known as the civil rights or women's suffrage movement in the United States history.